Psalms, chapter 49, verse 11. That in without is, that their houses shall continue forever.
That's it, man. Manifest destiny, man. They feel this inevitable that they have to rule, man, forever. That's why they set up all these statues and images, man. They show the pride of this place. Because they feel that there's no way possible that we ever going to be taken out of power, man. Because they feel that they don't have power. And the Most High don't have no reign over them, man.
Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Hashem, Rakah Kadash.
Double honors to the apostles and elders, the great millstone. Peace and blessings to the elect. It's brothers from GMS Houston Camp, man, and we just took a trip first over to the what they call the tribute to the founding fathers or statesmen, which will feature. It had the four statues that it had with Stephen F. Austin, Sam Houston, and George Washington, and Abraham Lincoln, the one they say claimed freed us, man. But these was four devils, man, that thrived on deception and stealing and capitalizing, man, to the agenda of these damn so-called white men, and that's all he's about, man. Real quick, somebody grab John 10 and 10. This is kind of going to be like a first installment to getting into some of this Texas history. And all the landmarks is deviled and erected to show you that this is the pride of this man, man. They came over here and did nothing but steal this land and commit genocide and murder like they've always done. But they label it, they change up words and label it as if they had to come over here and colonize this land, man, which is known as Texas today. Go ahead, bro.
This John chapter 10 and verse 10. The thief cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy.
Yep, and that's the so-called white man. That's all he shows up. He acts like he's coming in peace. But before long, now your people being oppressed and put to death, man. And this man is taking all your resources and land. Because originally, when Stephen F. Austin got out here, he was just continuing on agreement that his father had made with Mexico. And they had allowed them to come over here and get certain amount of land for settlers, man. But they didn't want to abide by the rules that Mexico had set for them, man. So they started what they call the Texas Revolution, but it's really was a Holocaust, man. And like this brother was looking up into before, hey, well, you can bring it out if you want, brother. You should look it up. Wherever you had found it.
It was on Etymology online, and it's the word Holocaust, mid-13th century, sacrificed by fire, burnt offering.
Yep, and that's what happened here, man. Like, the Negroes, Latinos, the Negroes think that they was the first ones burnt and shit. Man, Esau was doing that with Gad and Issachar way before that, man. They were scalping the dead bodies of the indigenous people that they killed, man, and burning their bodies, man. And they give reverence to their gods, man. So they every time they took over us, they had thanked their gods, man. And you see it just in this building behind us, man. I know the brother got some shots of it, man, but you got all type of Greek images, man. You got an Edomite with an Egyptian headdress symbol on the front of the City Hall building, man. This devil always, he gives credence to the gods and what he worship, man. So when they take over Jake, man, they give credit, man. Just like they did with Gad, when they took over, they gave credit to the god of Mars, man, the god of war. We'll read that again and then grab Psalm 49 and 11.
This is John, Salakia John, St. John 10 and 10.
Hey, this is why the scriptures tell you not to trust your enemy, man, because Issachar trusted Esau and made a pact with him, and these devils revolted against him, man. Go ahead.
The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy.
God, and that's it, man. When the so-called white man show up, there's nothing else in his heart but to steal, kill, and rob as much as he can, man, and to oppress the people furthermore. You'll bring out that article, brother, and then we'll get to the rest of the scriptures.
The article is from thewordpress.com. The title is The Texas Holocaust.
Speak up, son, too. All right.
We're going to read two paragraphs from it. That year, Austin authorized the formation of a U.S. colonial Texan militia and granted wide powers to the militia commander.
Hey, stop real quick. Look up the word militia. All right. Because, man, Esau real smooth the way he started rewording shit when they talk about history, man. They got tired of abiding by the Mexican rules and regulations that they set to come over here and colonize in certain areas, man. So what did he have to do? My brother gonna get the definition, but he had to raise up a military power. Why? If you're under a ruling government already, what do you need a military for? They're not oppressing you, they're not coming after you and pursuing you in any type of state of war. So why would he have to do this, man? Because he was about to revolt, getting ready to revolt, man. Because they got tired of having to convert and be Mexican citizens. And when Mexico had won when Mexico had gained its independence, they had done away with slavery, basically. And that's when Esau couldn't take it no more. Esau, hell no, we got to revolt and take this land over, man. But what did they do? They saw this is the Texas Revolution, man. But go ahead, brother. Whenever you get it, just bring it out.
That year, Austin authorized the formation.
Go ahead, Austin.
This militia on Wikipedia, and it says, a militia is generally an army or some other fighting organization or non-professional soldier citizen of a nation or subject of a state who can be called upon for military services during a time of need.
See, now they using it like they just raised up a military. No, you didn't have no need for it. You made an agreement with Mexico, and Esau done what he always did, man. He broke his agreement and raised up with a military power to go to war with the owner of the indigenous people of this land, man. Go ahead, but you had a precept?
Come. This is Genesis chapter 27. And I started at verse 38, okay, going into Esau. It says, and Esau said unto his father, hast thou but one blessing, my father? Bless me, even me also, O my father. And Esau lifted up his voice and wept. And Isaac his father answered and said unto him, behold, thy dwelling shall be the fatness of the earth and of the dew of heaven from above, and by thy sword shalt thou live, and shall serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have the dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck. Yeah, man. So Esau raising up a military, man. This is way of life, man, okay? This is a blessing that he received from the Heavenly Father, man, okay? Everything Esau did, he did it by war, man.
Yep.
And death and discretion, lying, man, deceived. But see, the Most High made him like that, man. All right?
That year, Austin authorized the formation of a U.S. colonial Texas militia and granted wide powers to the militia commander to make war against the Caracas.
That's wickedness, man. You had an agreement with these people and you said, man, fuck the agreement. Let's go to war. For what? Because you're a devil, man. This man will take your land and then put up all type of statues and tributes to his forefathers, which did nothing but commit a genocide and steal the land that they came upon, man. That's all this devil. That's why we ain't no reason to be trying to save no so-called white man. Because in the kingdom, all he would do is try to meditate, even though he won't be able to. He'll just be trying to see when he can try to get back in power, man. When can he rise up? But that won't happen once the kingdom of heaven is established, man. The so-called white man's reign of terror is over, man. We can get into this history, and it fuels us, man. It's going to give us that much appreciation to the Most High for giving us the kingdom, man. To take down this proud-ass devil, man. To tear down and burn all these images and statues that he'd have put up, man.
Just to add on to the brother's point in Genesis 27 and 41, it reads, And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, meaning his mind, the days of mourning for my father are at hand, then would I slay my brother Jacob. All right, and that's the mindset of Esau today. He hates the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that committed all this murder upon them because he hates us, man. Going back to the book of Genesis, man. Okay, Esau is the so-called white man today, and that's his mindset still today, man, to destroy us and cut us off from being the people because of the blessing we receive, man.
Austin planned the extermination and forced removal.
See, to read that again.
Austin planned the extermination and forced removal.
For extermination and forced removal, man. Do that sound like how in Texas history, man, when I was growing up here in Texas, man, they ain't worded like that, man. They made it seem like it was all hunky-dory and what happened just was a regular war. They don't go in to high started or nothing like that. They just, oh, we're gonna study the Texas Revolution, man, and learn about the father of Texas, Stephen F. Austin, which was a fucking devil, man. And the key word said extermination, man, and forced removal out of the land, man. But you got see the Sam Houston statue standing tall on the side of 45 North, man, in Huntsville, man. You got the Sandra Seno Monument with the tallest obelisk erected, man, where they took over Santa Ana, man, tributing to their rape, rob, and murder, man. But go ahead, brother.
It says, Austin planned the extermination and forced removal of the Iowa people so that he would be able to implement his mass U.S. colonization plan.
Yeah, this was part of the Texas annexation, man. Just going further into this devil, what he did with Gad, they couldn't get enough, man. That's his devil, he's greedy, man. He get a little bit and he gotta continue going on, man. Until they took over all over North America, man. And took part of Mexico and renamed it New Mexico and Texas, man. Go ahead, brother.
Austin's war led into the full-blown U.S. colonialist war of conquest in the territory known as the Texas Indigenous Wars.
And that's just some good information to go into, some good history, man. Well, it was the Texas Indigenous Wars, correct?
Yeah.
Fine. That's some good history to go into. It's called the Texas Indigenous Wars, man. And that's basically when Stephen F. Austin, when he raised up his military, when he started basically going on this conquest through Texas, man. Taking over. That's why these devils call him the father of Texas, man. How you gonna be the father of something and it was people already over here, a full-blown government. So they can't say it was savages when y'all had an official agreement with these people, man. But that's Issachar ass trusting the so-called white man. You can't play with this devil and not get burnt, man. It's almost done.
It's almost done.
Yeah, let's finish that out then. We can get
this was a U.S. war of genocide having the support of the U.S. federal government.
That's it. Because they try to act like Stephen F. Austin would just carry on with his father was like on some MLK type shit, not trying to integrate the people, but he said it was a quote that he said, and they said, oh, this is Moses Austin, the seer of the dream. And his dream was genocide, man. It wasn't no damn, they try to plant it like these devils just came over here and got oppressed by Mexico and they had to revolt and fight back. Which is complete bullshit, man.
Thousands of indigenous men, women, and children died from mass killing and from malnutrition and disease as a result of inflicted conditions. Some tribes became extinct during this physical genocide.
Yeah, that's the MO of the so-called white man, man. You great Stephen F. Austin, the father of Texas, which they didn't name the capital of Texas after, man. Austin, Texas, man. Sam Houston, man, any of these damn devils that they uplift as the founding fathers, man, was fucking wicked, man. Devils set up by the federal government to come take control of the land, man. And this was a major business move when Stephen F. Austin did this, man. They made major capital off this land, man. Go ahead, man. Get to the scripture.
This is Nahum chapter 3 and verse 1. All right. Woe to the bloody city. All right. It is full of lies and robbery. The prey departed not.
Yep, and that bloody city is talking about America, man. This land, starting from the east to west coast of America, man, is filled with blood of Israelites, man. And that bloody city done nothing but rape, rob, and murder, man. And through deceit and lies, man, showing up, look, we're going to make a treaty. We're going to make this agreement. But then they get back, hey, we got to take over this shit. Fuck this.
Words in his mouth were sweet as honey, but war was in his heart.
That's it, bro. And it say the prey departed not, man. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, we the prey, man. And we going into a little bit of Texas history, man. Now we touched on how Mexico was in control at first, and Esau had to give grants to come over here, granted permission to come over here and set up settlements, man. And then this devil turned around. Go to war with you, take over your land, give you a byword or a proverb to go by, man. And then after that, they tell you, you need to get out of here, man. Now you got Donald Trump trying to say he gonna build up a wall when y'all stole this land, man.
This Psalms, chapter 49, verse 11. Right. The end without is that their houses shall continue forever.
That's it, man. Manifest destiny, man. They feel this inevitable that they have to rule, man, forever. That's why they set up all these statues and images, man. They show the pride of this place. Because they feel that there's no way possible that we ever going to be taken out of power, man. Because they feel that they the ultimate power. And the Most High don't have no reign over them, man. That's why the scriptures tell you that the deceived and the deceiver are his, man. The Most High is in control of these devils, man. And he allowed you to, somebody grab Daniel 4 and 17. The Most High put you in this position, man. While y'all thanking all these different Greek and Roman gods for the triumph of your genocides, man, the Most High allowed that to happen to fulfill the curses that was put on us, man. So it's for us to receive our hell before the kingdom is established, man.
This is Daniel 4 and 17. This matters by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men.
And that's why, pursuant to the scripture the brother just read in Psalms 49 and 11, man, the Most High want them to feel like that, man. So when the Most High send the sun back to take this place over, they gonna know that the Most High power reigns, man. He lifted up these people to this high level and took them down without no effort, man. Go ahead, brother.
It says, and giveth it to whomsoever he will, and set it up over it the basis of men.
You Edomites, man. You are the basis of men, and the Most High lift you up with one intent, man, to do just like he did with Egypt, man. With the Roman Empire, the Babylonian Empire, man, the Greeks, man. Let you be known across the earth as this ultimate power, but the Most High is gonna take you down and all your goddamn statues and memorabilia that you left, man. Like you was just gonna continue to rule and nothing could ever happen to you, man. Yes,
it says, and their dwelling places to all generations, they call their lands after their own names.
That's it. They call their names after their slack. They call the lands after their own names, man. And they've been doing that all throughout history, man. And specifically here in Texas, man, what do you have? Well, we're in Houston, Texas right now, named after Sam Houston, man. Another devil, man. The city of Austin, Texas, who was named after Stephen F. Austin, the ultimate devil. And that's the capital of Texas, man. Showing you the pride of, that's why, like, down here, Texas history is big on Stephen F. Austin, man. Like, they emphasize a lot of effort in teaching you about this devil, man. Yeah, something else, man. Let's get that, the Wisdom of Solomon 2:1.
You want that, Daniel?
No, the brother just brought it
up. Okay, it's a lot.
Yeah, let's get that, Wisdom of Solomon 2:1. Y'all got it.
It's Wisdom of Solomon chapter 5 and verse 1.
Two and one.
Salakia. This is Wisdom of Solomon chapter 2, verse 1. For the ungodly said reasoning with themselves, but not aright. Our life is short and tedious.
Yep, man. And that's what this devil feels like, man. His life is short and tedious, so he got to go as hard as possible, man. Real quick, grab, somebody grab Revelation 12 and 12.
Revelation chapter 12 and 12. Therefore rejoice ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he had but a short time.
Yep, this devil, that's all he done, man. As soon as he hit the ground running, man. Committing all type of wickedness and genocide, man. To build up his rulership and continue on that way, man. To the point, so like when this brother was reading that article, man, and it lets you know in the Georgia Guidestones, man, they plan on cutting the population down, man. They talking about the overall population, man. But for you Jakes, you not in the picture in their future, man. Go ahead, brother.
And in death of a man, there is no remedy.
Yep, this is where your YOLO come from. When you niggas think y'all just doing everything so hip, and for the first time, this is Esau's mind frame, man. You only live once, man, so live it up to the fullest. Go ahead.
Neither was there any man known to have returned from the grave.
So that show you they don't believe in Yahweh Shai, man. There's no way this man rose resurrected. That's why they so big on setting up. The only man that could have done that had to have been a so-called white man. Ain't no way no nigga done that. Yeah, something you were saying?
No.
Go ahead, brother.
For we are born at all adventure, and we shall be hereafter as though we had never been.
Yep, so they saying after we die, that's it, man. Our name is forgotten, man. That's why they so gung-ho on erecting all these statues, man, so they can leave their mark in history, man, for the generations to come. Read about me. Look what I did, man, which was all our wickedness, man. Against the apple of the Most High's eye. Y'all, you devils think you're not gonna pay for that shit? And you continuing to oppress Jake on all levels, man? Acting like you calling Issachar and other nations immigrants, man? And fuck the other nations with the Israelites, man. You calling the Israelites immigrants, man? Telling Judah you need to go back to Africa. Well, you need to go back to the Caucasus Mountains. Where the hell you from, man? Y'all didn't get over here the first ones, man, and basically what they say, they brought civilization to America, which is bullshit, man. The Aztec Empire was one of the most civilized cities that you could be in, man. They had irrigation systems, man. They had toothpaste. They had hygiene, man. You devils came over here with tooth decay, disease, rats. And you have to learn from Gad and Issachar, man, just to survive, man. But we the savages, man. What, man, this place was a paradise before you fucking devils got here, man. Now we walking on all this concrete, man. We got fake plants everywhere.
It's Numbers 35 and 33. So you shall not pollute the land where ye are. For blood, it defileth the land.
This is the law. Go ahead.
And the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it.
Yep, by the blood of him that shed it, man. You so-called white people, you damn Edomites, man. Y'all gonna pay for all the rape, rob, and murder and the bloodshed that you committed on this earth and throughout the world, man. In America and throughout the world, man. That's how the Most High is gonna cleanse this place, man. With blood and nuclear fire, man. Ain't no goddamn Black Panther movie gonna change the way it is in America, man. Ain't no marching and all this bullshit. Only thing, see, these devils, Most High gave them the sword as their blessing, so because they knew that's how they was gonna have to take over, man. That's why the Most High only dealing with the men of the Lord, because we understand that this is war, man. And we waiting on the ultimate war when Yahweh Shai come back, and Lord willing, we be side by side with him, taking this place down, man. executing the final judgment on this place, man. Yes,
sir. This is Jeremiah 49:12. For thus say Yahweh, behold, they whose judgment was not to drink of the cup have assuredly drunk
it. And we did it. We drank the shit out of that cup. We drank it, man, took our finger and wiped the rim of the cup, everything, man. Go ahead.
And art thou he that shall altogether go unpunished? Thou shalt not go unpunished, but thou shalt surely drink of it.
Yep, that drink is talking about the hell that y'all put on us, man.
Slavery?
Yep, slavery, man. It's gonna come on to y'all double, man. Y'all gonna drink the like the scripture, you gonna drink the dregs of the cup, man. That warm, hot foam and shit, y'all gonna drink every bit of this hell that the Most High is gonna put it on y'all, man. But he's gonna do it by his son and go on down through the order, man. We gonna get a hand in doing that, man. Even two-thirds that get put to death. Man, you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans in America, y'all gonna get a hand at fucking these devils up in the kingdom, man. Well, I wanna get a hand on it the first go around, man. I want to be in the new history in the kingdom as one of the ones that took down this place, man. That endured to the end, man. That erased this bullshit-ass history that America had put out, man. As if they just came over here and civilized a beast of people, man. You got something you want to say?
Nah, I'm ready to preach something.
Yeah, God.
Lamentations 4:21.
Shit.
Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom, that dwellest in the land of Uz. The cup also shall pass through unto thee.
That's it, man. And what is that cup? Indignation, man. And it's righteous indignation that the Most High have forever, man. So can't no white people be, so-called white people be saved, man. And no damn Edomites gonna make it on the chariot, man. So you said for that to happen, because the deliverance is gonna happen by the chariots, man. So you saying that if Esau can be saved, you saying these devils can receive a glorious body, man. Are you out your fucking mind, man? All this devil done, and you think the Most High gonna allow them to receive a glorious body, man? That's why two-thirds of you gotta go with these devils, man. Go ahead, brother.
It says, thou shalt be drunken and shalt make thyself naked.
That's it, man. This devil's being exposed, man. That's to show you that this kingdom is being fallen, man. It's fallen. Because all his secrets are being brought out, man. And not just by, first off, by the men of the Lord, the prophets exposing you constantly, man. But you got other Edomites going against the rulers of this world, man. Going against their own kind, man. That show you that this kingdom has to fall, man, because it's divided amongst its own, man. Even amongst the elite, they not sitting there at peace with each other. They jockeying for position. Because they devils, man. Go ahead.
This Jeremiah chapter 30 and verse 16. Therefore, well, I start at 15. This Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 15. Why criest thou for thine affliction? Thy sorrow is incurable for the multitude of thy iniquity. All right, talking to you Israelites, man. The brother going into the history, how the Edomites came over here and destroyed our people, put them to slavery, made certain agreements with them, all right, broke the agreements. But all this was because you rebelled against your heaven, against your power, man. All right, against the Yahweh by Shimei Awashah, all right, gave us the laws, man. All right, and our people went against those laws, so you have to be punished for that, man. It's a consequence, all right. Therefore, we in our captivity today, all right. And it reads, because thy sins are increased, I have done these things unto you. Because we went off, that's the reason we in captivity, man. All right, verse 16. Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thine adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity.
Every one of them.
Tell you, bro.
What? Oh, that's the Old Testament, though. You can't read that. That's the right. Old. That the Lord changed that.
Right.
Nah, he came to fulfill the law, man.
Right.
He came to be the ultimate sacrifice to bring us back under the adoption, man. And that's it, man. The Most High didn't send his son back to open up salvation to no other nation, man. He's talking about Israelite foreigners, man. But it said the key point of that scripture was all thine enemies will be taken down, man. All they that devour you shall be devoured, man. Because Jake trying to make the excuse now, it's our fault. we broke the laws. Yeah, but Esau still got a pain, man.
Right.
Yeah, the scripture say that, man. Look, bro. That passage with the brother just read, man. It said that Israel went off.
Right.
Then Yahweh punished us.
Right.
And how he punished us? By sending the other nations on us, man.
Right.
He made Esau and other nations punish us, but he's gonna punish them for punishing us, man. That's cold, yeah. Bro. That's cold. Y'all don't know about Yahweh, man.
Yeah.
Now look, this is why everybody's so bugged out concerning the Bible. They think the Bible contradicting enough. No, bro.
Yeah.
This the will of the Heavenly Father. Hey, y'all
it'll say his thoughts are not of our thoughts.
Yeah,
our thoughts are not of his thoughts.
They're not.
Yeah, you finish a little bit more on this.
Yeah.
And it says, can I get a real quick one? Because you were talking about Christians would say this in the Old Testament. This Malachi 3:6. For I am Yahweh, I change not. Therefore ye sons of Jacob are not consumed, man. So what the Old Testament say is not done away with. Everything in the Old Testament that applies through prophecy is going to happen, man. The Most High ain't changed his mind. All right.
Yeah, that prophecy the brother read inside Jeremiah 30:16. That ain't happened yet, man.
Yeah, that ain't happened yet.
So what the fuck y'all talking about, man? But see, the Christian church teaches that Jesus came to fulfill all things.
Right. He
changed his mind. And so now, in the kingdom of him, everybody gonna be joined together, love. No, man.
Right.
According to prophecy, man, the Lord Yahweh shall come back to get some slaves, man.
Right.
And to establish his glory on the earth, man. Okay?
Right. So this Jeremiah 30:16 in the middle. And it says, and they that spoil thee shall be a spoil. All right, taking our lands, taking the resources from the natives that's already here. All right, taking the spoil, you're going to be a spoil. The scriptures say you will go into captivity, man. All right, every one of them. And then I think it's, what's the scripture that say everybody had a part, hand in our captivity?
Yeah.
So all you nations going to have to drink of that cup, man. But Esau mainly, man. All right? And then it reads, and all they that pray upon thee will I give for a prey. And you see that today, man. Praying upon us, man, that with different laws, all right, different secret councils, they praying on us, man. That's why we in these lower states, the crack epidemic, that happened, all right. You got what they got, Section 8, feminism, all this. Esau praying on us. You gonna be for a prey, man, in the kingdom of heaven,
hey,
all right.
Just to kind of stay in line with the main topic of what we was focused on, man.
Right.
They still pursuing Issachar to this day, man. And yeah, and got them as a prey, man. The first time I had took a bus from Houston back to California, man, and going through Southern America, South North America, basically the Southwest side, man, going through, you travel straight across Texas first, then you go through New Mexico, Arizona, and shit like that, man. But all through that point, you got border checkpoints, man. So every time you get into another state, they getting on the bus and they go through the bus and they ask everybody real quick, are you a U.S. citizen? They wasn't worried about Judah, they wasn't worried about nobody. If they actually a U.S. citizen and you like yes, and they'll just move on. But if you was a so-called Mexican and they ask you, they gonna present your green card, show me your paperwork. And if you ain't got the right paperwork, they snatching your ass off that bus, man. It's a clear example of how this devil steady praying on Israel, man, after you stole his land, man.
Yeah, and then also just real quick, man, you know, I wanna get off the subject, but these groups, out of all the spots where they can see that at this part, they can't even see right here because they wanna listen to what we're talking about, man. Okay? They are interested in what we are saying because niggas don't do this, man. Okay?
Yeah. They really wanna get a picture.
Yeah, to them this is foreign. Alright, because back at home in their lands, they see the nigga woman shaking her ass,
yeah.
Jake sagging with tattoos all on his body, smoking weed, being a monkey, man. But yet they see this and they
baffled.
Yeah, they all baffled and bugged out, man. And so they gonna sit right there the whole time to see what we saying, man. All right, but little do they know, we're reading about them going into slavery, man.
Yeah,
right.
Y'all, look, get ready to go into captivity, man.
Yeah, cause none of the other nations is over here in Texas crying out for Issachar. Saying, I mean, how y'all gonna send them back when y'all stole this land, man?
Yeah.
Go ahead, man.
That was it on that.
It's a good concubine for this kingdom, man.
Yeah, that was it on that.
Yeah. Yeah, real quick, man. You know, concerning the brother was talking about how Esau was calling the tribes on this side of the world savages, man. Well, this is a book called The Devastation of the Indies by Bartolomé de las Casas, and this is the account that he gave on Ephraim, man, inside of the island of Hispaniola, which is Puerto Rico today, man. This is the account that he gave me on them, man. He says, this page 28, he says, and of all the infinite universe of humanity, these people are the most guileless,
man,
the most devoted of wickedness and duplicity, the most obedient and faithful to their native masters and to the Spanish Christians whom they serve. They are by nature the most humble, patient, and peaceable, holding no grudges, free from embroilments, neither excitable nor quarrelsome. These people are the most devoid of rancors, hatreds, or desire for vengeance of any people in the world. So, according to the Christian doctrine, these people will have so-called Christian characteristics, right? But yet y'all came over here claiming that these people were some damn savages and demons, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yet they were nice, humble, peaceable unto you. Okay, showing you how to hunt. Okay, showing you how to clean your ass, man.
Yeah, how to store up corn in the winter.
But yet, Columbus had took that. He had said, he said they were too nice unto him, man. He said that he had to take them over because they were too nice, man. And so the devil had took them down, man. Okay, but y'all gave a false account of the so-called Indians on this side of the world, man.
Okay.
They were good people, man. Why? Because they Israelites, man.
Hey, bring out that definition for savage and then read that again to see if the definition for savage line up with the description that this man left, who now is for Ephraim, Puerto Ricans, right?
Yeah.
Come. Go ahead.
This savage on etymon.com, and it's an adjective, savage. Mid-13th century. Fierce, furious, wild, undomestic, untamed, savage, wild, untamed, strange, pagan.
You devils didn't even brush your teeth until you got over here and met the Aztecs. You dirty pieces of shit. Go ahead, brother, read that again. You got the definition for savage, man. Untamed, wild, man.
It says, and of all the infinite universe of humanity.
In the infinite universe of humanity.
These people are the most guileless.
Guileless, man. With the scripture, man, you having no guile, found no guile in these people, man.
Yep.
Go ahead.
The most devoted of wickedness and duplicity.
Yep, man. Showed you they was keeping the law, statutes, and commandments, man. They wasn't going 100%, man, but Israel always kept certain laws that they adhered to, man, because it just was natural.
Right.
Go ahead.
And real quick, our law tell us to be like this, man. Okay, to be peaceable unto your brother, to love your neighbor, man. Okay, to be to be a help unto your brother, man.
Yeah.
All right, to show these so-called, of the world called godly characteristics, man. All right? But our law teaches to be nice, man. Right. Okay, teach us how to help order amongst ourselves, man. And this is what they saw when they came over here, man.
Yep.
Okay?
And they saw a perfect opportunity, man.
Yep.
Let's play it cool, then we about to fuck them up.
Right. So that gang violence shit didn't come over here to Esau, brought his savage ass over here, man.
The so-called white man, the first gangster in the earth, man.
Right.
Okay,
Christopher
Columbus, them were fucking gangsters, man.
Yeah.
Robbers.
Yeah.
All right, Sam Houston, Stephen F. Off, all you niggas, man, with a bunch of gangsters and gangbangers, man.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to see examples of savages and untamed wild beasts? Look what happens after a Final Four win. After the World Cup for hockey?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So when you see these college students and these fans of these damn professional teams, that's an example of savages. You see a whole bunch of Edomites, man. After the Eagles won, Esau went fucking crazy, man. Yeah. Flipping cars, man. And then what they say on the news? Oh, this was just celebration. No, man. A bunch of savages showing their true fucking colors, man.
It says, the most obedient and faithful to their native masters and to the Spanish Christians whom they serve. They are by nature the most humble, patient, and peaceable, holding no grudges, free from all embroilments, neither excitable nor quarrelsome. These people are the most devoid of rancors, hatred, or desire for vengeance of any people in the world. Yeah, man, so they were just, you know, going to show you, man, that the natives that was on this side of the world was a peaceful people, man, clean and humble. You so-called white people came over here like animals, man. As it gave a counter here, you know what? Let me read that, man. This is page 29, man. It says, talking about the Spaniard Christians, man, okay? Columbus, them. It says, page 29, yet in this sheepfold, into this land of meat outcasts, there came some Spaniards who immediately behaved like raven and wild beasts, wolves, tigers, or lions that have been starved for many days. So y'all came over here acting like animals, man. Beasts and lions, man.
Yeah.
Because of the killing, the murder, the lion, man. All right, all the nasty things y'all were doing, the raping the women, okay? Taking the baby and smashing the baby to the stones, man. Goddamn animals, man. But yet y'all had the nerve to call them savages, man. And devils. Y'all gotta pay for that, man. Yeah, that was it on that.
Isaiah chapter 33 and verse 1. Woe to thee that spoilest, and thou was not spoiled.
And thou was not spoiled, man. This brother just read an account on the characteristics of Ephraim, man. And when they came upon them, man, they didn't spoil you. They didn't do anything to oppress you or attack you, man. And you damn near wiped Ephraim out, man. Go ahead.
And dealest treacherously, and they dealt not treacherously with thee.
Yeah, unfair, unbalanced devil, man. You see a peaceful people, instead of remaining at peace with them, keeping your word on what you agreed to, man, you turn around and stab them in the back in an ultimate way, man.
Hey, real quick, brother. Concerning your brother talking about how Esau almost wiped out Ephraim, man. This book goes into that, man. Okay, this is page 29. All right, the same paragraph, it says, this island of Hispaniola, once so populous, having a population that I estimated to be more than 3 million, has now a population of barely 200 persons. Bro, you went from 3 million people to 200 people, man.
That sounds like savages to me.
Shit. Esau is ruthless, man. But see, that's the spirit that the Heavenly Father gave him, man. To fulfill prophecy, bro. But,
yeah.
Bro, I'm telling you, man. Y'all, look. Once we establish back at the power, man, y'all gonna wish, all right, that we had some goddamn Black Panther power, man. And the kingdom of heaven gonna have some power out of this world, man. Okay, a Black Panther ain't shit, man.
Yeah.
All right, a goddamn cat suit. Or whatever he is, yeah. Yeah, a pound of goddamn cat suit, man. No, man. Bro, we gonna have new bodies, man. All right, to do ineffable things, man.
We ain't gonna have to hide behind masks.
Yeah, hiding and shit.
And be going society and be the normal person that day.
True.
Nah, fuck that, man. Y'all gonna know who's oppressing you, whooping your ass, and ruling over you, man. We gonna remind you every second of the kingdom, man. And when you mending to you, when y'all sit up there, Edomite Hunstover and his other Edomite Pat putting ointment on his back,
trying to
mend his wounds during the Sabbath, you still gonna be in fear. Cause soon as the sun come set again, that's we back on your ass, man.
That's right.
For all the fucking the hell you put on these Negro Latinos and Native Americans, man. You ain't gonna get away with it, man. Regardless of us going off, the Most High already got it written, man. He whooped and disciplined his children, man, up until the point of death, man. For 2/3 of you Negro Latinos and Native Americans, he put hell on all of us as a nation, man. But he got a reward. He gonna make good on his word, man. That's why our big brother Yahweh Shah went up on the cross and took on all our sins, man. To bring us back under the fold with the Heavenly Fathers, man, with the Friendly Father, man, to bridge that gap we had lost, man. Yeah. Go ahead.
Good. When thou shalt cease to spoil, thou shalt be spoiled. And when thou shalt make an end to deal treacherously, that they shall deal treacherously with thee.
That's it, man. Because what do the scriptures say about Gad, man? It said, troops shall overcome at the end, man.
Right.
On top of when the northern and southern tribes come back together, you gonna catch hell, but when Yahweh Shah crack them clouds, it's a wrap for you devils, man.
Yeah,
we can get back to the Wisdom of Solomon.
Okay.
It's Wisdom of Solomon chapter 2 and verse 1. It was verse 2. For we are born in all adventure, and we shall be hereafter as though we had never been. For the breath in our nostril is as smoke and a little spark in the moving of our heart. Which being extinguished, our body shall be turned into ashes, and our spirit shall vanish as the soft air. Verse 4. And our name shall be forgotten in time, and no man shall have our work in remembrance.
Yep, that's why they gotta leave behind all these monuments of the men, their forefathers of wickedness, man.
Right.
Because they feel that if they don't remind people, they gonna be forgotten in time, man. That's why this devil's so proud, man, of leaving landmarks everywhere he done committed his wickedness, man. Setting up overlords wherever he took over people in a wicked way, man.
Right.
Go ahead.
It's really like a slap in the face, but our people don't know.
That's it. Really the pride. It's pride. Like I'm gonna put my statue here and why I conquered you, man. When we had stopped by Sam Houston statue in Huntsville one time, you had little Iskarites taking pictures in front of the fucking statue, man. Show you how gone our people are, man. They don't even know who the enemy is, man. You on this land because you done been Americanized now, and you let your damn children take pictures on the man who helped conquer your land, man. Hey, but you saw your conquest in the Americas and throughout the earth is not gonna go unanswered, man. Go ahead, brother.
And our life shall pass away as the trace of a cloud, and shall be dispersed as a mist that is driven away with the beams of the sun and overcome with the heat thereof. For our time is a very shadow that passeth away. And after our end, there is no returning. For it is fast sealed, so that no man cometh again. Come on, therefore, let us enjoy the good things that are present. And let us speedily use the creatures like as in youth.
And that's what they're doing to this day, man. They enjoying the fatness of the earth right now, man, and continue to oppress Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Up until the point now, man, we're going to jump down too, man, to verse 12. Cause we'll start at 11. Start at 10. So, jump down to verse 10, because it's going to show you, because of them feeling like there ain't no coming back after this, the characteristics are really the plan of what they did and doing, man. Go ahead.
Are you sure we're going to start at 9?
God, go ahead.
Let none of us go without his part of voluptuousness.
Yep. Hey, Esau, take care of Esau if you part of the so-called blue bloods, man. Are you part of the elites, man? Esau, take care of his people, except for the low-level motherfucker, but they still got things like white privilege in society, man. They still get that white pass, man. They still get a job just because they used to babysit Edomite kids 12 years ago. Oh, I know him since he was a child. Give him the job. We don't have those privileges in this society. So all you fucking devils is getting some type of part off of the labor and bloodshed off of Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Go ahead.
Let us leave tokens of our joyfulness in every place.
Pan around, brother. We'll get this and man the other side, man. Let us leave tokens of our joyfulness, man. Slaps in the face everywhere, man. Go ahead.
For this is our portion and our lot is this.
And our lot is this. Go ahead.
Let us oppress the poor righteous man.
Man, that let us oppress the poor righteous man. I didn't say let us go after a wicked, savage nation. This is the true mindset of them, man. We got to go after them ones that claim they the righteous, man. We got to go after these children of Israel, man. Yeah, he wiping out his own kind, these other nations, but his finger is pointed on Israel, man. Because he know the promises to us, man. This is our natural born enemy, man. Go ahead.
Let us not spread the widow, nor reverence the ancient gray hairs of the age.
Yep, this devil don't say, oh, well, those are old, these are the elderly, these are women and kids. We go, nah, man. When Esau come, he wiping everybody out, man. That's why we don't play games and try to be hand in hand with this devil, man. We be wise in society and do what we gotta do to survive here, man. But we know that we just waiting on the time when we get to take over this place through the power of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, man. Go ahead.
God, it reads, let our strength be the law of justice, for that which is feeble is bound to be nothing worth. Therefore, let us lie in wait for the righteous.
Let us lie in wait for the righteous, man. Go ahead.
Because he is not for our turn.
He is not for our turn. And the scripture's about to tell you why. What are the prophets doing right now? Exposing this devil day in and day out, man. We're standing boldly against him, man. Go ahead.
And he is clean contrary to our doings.
Yep, go ahead.
He upbraided us with our offending of the law.
That's why we get on this devil's ass, man. On top of it, everything's out of order right now. Everything this devil has done and continues to do is against the law of the Heavenly Father, and we're not going to sit back and stand by it. That's why the devil got to be taken out of power completely, man. Because he wasn't designed to be righteous, man. But we have to go through our curses and catch our hell, take our ass whooping like men, and now we're doing this work, man. We going against this devil spiritually right now, man. And Lord willing, if we be part of that number, the Most High grant us the spiritual powers physically, man, to take this place out, man. Go ahead. Right.
And objected to our infamy, the transgressing of our education.
Go ahead.
Right. Verse 13. He professed to have the knowledge of the Most High. And he called himself the child of the Lord.
Hey, man, we can stop right there, man. But that's a good chapter to finish reading, man. But this is the devil. He know who's set up to be the righteous, man. And he's not going to stop until he's completely wiped out Jake, man. But the Most High's not going to let that happen, man. He's going to upset your new world order, man. He's going to upset all your plans to wipe out Jake finally, man. Hey, man, death to all these fucking Edomites, man, that's here in America until you elites, man. Get your ass ready for slavery, man. And really don't get ready. Continue to live it up. So it's going to be from up here to down here, man. At the snap of a finger, man. All your conquests, all your genocides, it won't come to the ultimate fruition that you plan, man. And with that, man, we're going to wrap this up, man. And Lord willing, we're going to continue to get into some Texas history and filter it through the scriptures, man. But once again, we want to give all praise, honor, and glory
to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushua, Ba'ashem, Rekha Kadash.
Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace and blessings to the elect. Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.